Welcome to the lab of electronic devices and circuits, and now we'll see experiment number 2, which is build and test single stage CS amplifier using FET, and we'll find out the values of AV, RI and RO. So now here I will keep the same value, same circuit which we have already built in experiment number 1. So in experiment number 1, which circuit we have built, which is self-bias circuit using FET. So self-bias circuit using FET I will keep constant as it is with same value. This was our circuit. The VDD that we have used, which is 12 volt. Then RD we have used, which is 2.2 kilo ohm. This was FET and we have used, which is BFW10, which is N channel JFET. Then RS that we have used was 1 kilo ohm. And then RG that we have used is 1 mega ohm. So we have used same circuit that we already built in experiment number 1. Here we are going to do amplification. What do you mean by amplification? Amplifier means your input is small signal which is having small magnitude, and output should be, the magnitude of output voltage should be very high. So here we want AC signal. In experiment 1 we have not used any AC signal. So that was clearly DC analysis. Here we do AC analysis. So what do you mean by basically small signal? Because here for input we are giving small signal. Small signal means the amplitude of the input signal, which is AC voltage, which is sinusoidal, which is to be given to the input circuit, must be having small magnitude, so that the output characteristic should be in a linear region, because in linear region we know your MOSFET acts as an amplifier. So if you want to operate my FET on MOSFET as an amplifier, then your MOSFET should be in linear region characteristic. Linear region characteristic means in that your Q point is linear region, that means Q point acts as an amplifier. If we give high amplitude signal, that is large signal, then MOSFET will become in either in ohmic region, which is non-saturation region, or either in cutoff region. Especially in non-saturation region, which is ohmic region, if MOSFET gets, then your Q point is nearer to the non-saturation region and your output voltage will be distorted, or either they may be clipped. So we will not get what we have amplification or amplified signal. So for that we used to give AC signal. But basically what is this AC signal? This is called as AC signal. As time passes, say this is amplitude, amplitude is varying as time passes. So say this is a reference line, that is zero reference line. So this consists of AC component as well as DC component. And as this signal is given to the input of FET, FET will amplify the signal, because this is small signal and we operate over FET in saturation region. So basically this AC component will also get amplified and DC component will also get amplified. And if your DC component will also get amplified here in this case, then your MOSFET may either go in non-saturation region and it acts as a switch. So I don't want my MOSFET or FET acts as a switch. So I should block this DC component. So I want to block the DC signal and I want to pass only AC signal, and hence I will use capacitors. So I will use here certain capacitors. So this capacitor couples input and the FET gate circuit. So we call it as coupling capacitor, which is CC1, say. This is my small signal. We call it as source voltage. Okay. So we consider this is 100 millivolt peak to peak and 1 kilohertz sinusoidal AC signal. So this we call as a small signal, and this is to be given to the input, that is gate of FET. This is drain, say, this is source, through coupling capacitor. We'll keep coupling capacitor value as 10 microfarad. Similarly, there can be output side also we have DC voltage, so that should be again blocked. So I will use that output, again one coupling capacitor, say CC2, which is 10 microfarad. Here is your output voltage. But as it is amplifier, my input signal is small signal and output signal should be of high amplitude. But if you see the output voltage, which is basically output is VDS, But here VDS and we have IDRS. So current flow through RS is ID. And if current flows through RS, then we have voltage drop. So if my voltage is dropped, my output voltage will get reduced. But that conflicts the concept of amplification. So I don't want to reduce my output voltage at output. And I want RS in the circuit because it imposes negative feedback. So I will use certain capacitor, that is bypass capacitor. Means this capacitor will bypass the signal which flows through RS and which will bypasses the signal, and this particular signal will never flow through RS. So what is the meaning? Here I will use one coupling capacitor, that is CS. It is called as source capacitor, source bypass capacitor, sorry, CS, and which is of having high value, say 100 microfarad. So why we are using the value of CS high? Because this is nothing but 100 microfarad value, that is nothing but capacitance. If we found out the reactance, because we know the formula of reactance, reactance is XCS, which is 1 upon 2 pi FCS. So first of all, what is the meaning of reactance? Reactance means resistance across capacitor. If the value of capacitance is very high, the reactance value is very less. Means reactance across this capacitor is very less. So this reactance value is very less, and it is such a very less as compared to 1 kilo, it is so big. So when signal flows and when signal comes here, signal will always prefer low resistive path. So as compared to 1 kilo ohm, the reactance across this is still less than 1 kilo ohm, and definitely signal will prefer this path to flow, and signal will bypass this particular path, and hence the signal will never flow through RS and there will not be any voltage drop expressed at output. So that is the meaning of source bypass capacitor. So I will use source bypass capacitor of having value 100 microfarad, which is very high as compared to this coupling capacitors. So this is our complete circuit. Now what we are going to find out, we are doing an AC analysis. Means we are first of all we will find out a voltage gain, then input impedance, and then output impedance. Now we'll see the procedure. Now this circuit will build on breadboard. So after building the circuit on breadboard, we'll give 100 millivolt peak to peak 1 kilowatt signal we'll generate from function generator with the help of CRO, and this output voltage is to be observed on CRO. Now first of all, the first thing that we know is input voltage, which is 100 millivolt peak to peak. So after constructing the circuit on breadboard, definitely I will get output voltage. So found out output voltage, that is VO. The third thing is gain, voltage gain, AV, which is output voltage upon input voltage, which is unitless quantity. And this is our first parameter to find. The fourth thing is, we are going to find out input impedance, that is RI of the circuit. So for that, a slight modification is to be made in the circuit, such a way that in between this input coupling capacitor and input voltage, we'll use one resistor, say which is R, which is of 1 mega ohm. If a resistor is connected in between capacitor and source voltage, then your output voltage will get reduced. And that output voltage we call as VOS. So we will observe an output voltage on CRO. After that, we will find out AVS, which is voltage gain with R, that R and I have connected an input side, which is basically ratio of VOS and VIN. VIN I will not keep varying, I will keep VIN constant, which is 100 millivolt peak to peak. So I can able to find out AVS, which is again unitless quantity. So once I get AVS, I already know the value of AV and I already know the value of R, which is 1 mega ohm. So there is a very famous formula. AVS is equal to AV into RI upon RI plus R. In this case, RI is nothing but input impedance of this circuit that I want to find. So R is known, which is 1 mega ohm. AVS is already known. AV is already known. So RI is unknown. So from this formula, we can able to find out RI value. Similarly, we will find out RO, that is output impedance of the circuit. So for output impedance, we have to again modify the circuit. The R which we have already connected, which is 1 mega ohm in between source and capacitor, now that I have to remove. And I want to do the circuit as it is that I have used originally. Now to find out RO, I will use one resistor which is across output voltage. Say this is RL, which is of value 1 kilo ohm. So RL is equal to 1 kilo ohm. So once we make this circuit, RL is equal to 1 kilo ohm, I will find out certain voltage and output, and I will call that output voltage as VO dash. Then the very famous formula of RO is VO minus VO dash upon VO dash into RL. We have already found out the value of VO from the second parameter. VO dash we just found out here because I have connected RL in the circuit. So RO is VO minus VO dash upon VO dash into RL. RL value is 1 kilo. So similarly now in this case we can able to find out RO. So in this experiment our basic aim is to find out AV, RI, RO. Similarly we will find phase shift between input and output signal. So what is the phase difference between input and output signal? If input signal is like this, so output signal is amplified and phase shifted by 180 degrees. So that is a theoretical aspect. So we will observe this 180 degree phase shift between input and output on CRO at a time. So these are the four parameters, AV, RI, RO and phase difference. But all these reading practically that we have to obtain, we have to verify with the theoretical. So now we will do the theoretical AC analysis of the circuit. So we have already this circuit. Now in case of theoretical analysis, we have to replace this FET by small signal model and all other circuit is remain as it is. Now I will draw this small signal equivalent circuit of this FET. So remember that in small signal equivalent circuit, however the capacitor that you have used, that should be short circuited, and whatever the DC voltages that you have used, that should be ground. So here in small signal equivalent circuit, this VDD becomes ground, then these capacitors become short circuited, this capacitor becomes also short circuited, and now we have to redraw the circuit by replacing this FET symbol by small signal model. Now I will draw this circuit directly. Replaced by directly a symbol. So this is EGS. This is GM into VGS. This is RD. This is what we have small signal model of N channel JFET. This is gate terminal, this is drain terminal, and this is source terminal. This is ground. And now what other circuitry that we have with us, that is we have RG in the circuit and we have input voltage, that is V in. Similarly at output we have RD in the circuit and here we will obtain output voltage. This is ID. So this is basically current source GM into VGS. This is voltage across gate and source is VGS and this is V. So now this is our complete circuit. Here we will find out RI and here we will find out RO. RD is the dynamic drain resistance. Basically the value of RD is dependent on the value of output impedance. So RD is 1 upon YOS. YOS is output impedance of 10 channel JFET. So output impedance of BFW10 that is to be obtained from the datasheet, and from BFW10 datasheet the value of YOS is basically 85 microseconds. So the value of RD is 85 microseconds. So similarly you can find out value of RD. Now we'll do AC analysis of the circuit. Now first of all we'll find out what is Vin. Vin is nothing but this VGS. Second is, what is VO? VO is to be obtained from this. So VO is, by Ohm's law, VO is equal to V, voltage is current into resistor. So this is the current, that is GM into VGS. And this current direction is opposite in the current direction that flows through this ID. So this is generally to be treated as minus. Okay. And there is one more reason that why we are using minus, because input and output phase difference is 180 degrees. So that means there is a 180 degree phase shift between input voltage and output voltage, and hence the output voltage is in minus. So what is the current? That is GM into VGS. This is current. And what is the resistance? So from the circuit it appears that RD, small RD and the capital RD, they are coming parallel. So this will become RD parallel with capital RD. The third one is the gain, which is AV. So that is output voltage upon input voltage, which is just a ratio of this quantity with this quantity. So in this case, VGS is common thing that is to be cut. So this will become minus GM into RD parallel with capital RD. So GM can be found out because we have the formula for GM. GM is equal to GMO into 1 minus VGS divided by VP. So what is GMO? We know that formula for GMO is minus 2 IDSS upon V pinch into 1 minus VGS divided by V pinch. So as we have used same circuit which we have built in experiment number 1, so we know the value of IDSS. IDSS that we have used in experiment number 1 was 10 milliampere. V pinch that we have used in experiment number 1 was minus 5 volt, and VGS was minus 2.5 volt. So if we put these values, like IDSS is 10 milliampere, V pinch is minus 5 volt, and VGS is minus 2.5 volt. The GM value, if you put this value, then we get GM is 2 millisiemens. So once we get the value of GM 2 millisiemens, we will find out RD. So now what is this 1 upon 85 microsecond that we will find? So we will get the value of RD, which is 1 upon 85 microsecond is 11.76 kilo ohm. So we'll put this value of RD, which is 11.76 kilo ohm. We know the value of RD, which is 2.2 kilo ohm. And 11.16 kilo ohm parallel with 2.2 kilo ohm into 2 millisiemens. So we'll get the value of gain is minus 3.7. So this is the theoretical reading of gain. Similarly, we can find out fourth one is Rin. Rin that is called Ri, which is nothing but just the resistance that appear across this branch, that is Rg. That is Rg, and that we know, which is 1 mega ohm. Similarly, we can find out Ro, which is the fifth parameter. Ro is the output resistance that is to be observed from all this side. So which is nothing but the parallel combination of this Rd and this capital Rd. So we can have this RD parallel with capital RD. So we can have 11.76 kilo ohm parallel with 2.2 kilo ohm. So the value of RO that we have with us is 1.85 kilo ohm. So value of RO becomes 1.85 kilo ohm. Similarly, theoretically we know the input voltage and output voltage is 180 degree phase shifted. So theoretically, we know the sixth one, theoretically, phi is equal to 180 degree. So what is the meaning of verification of practical value and theoretical value? Practically, whatever the value we have found out, that is AV, RI, RO and phase difference. And theoretically, the value of AV is minus 3.7, the value of RI is 1 mega ohm, the value of RO is 1.85 kilo ohm, and the phase difference is 180 degree. That is to be verified. That is experiment second. Thank you. Number 2, this is build and test single stage FET CS amplifier. So this is a circuit diagram that already we have discussed of single stage FET CS amplifier. Now in experiment number 1, we have already implemented this circuit on breadboard. Now we'll just modify this circuit because second experiment is just a modification of first experiment. So now we'll connect coupling capacitor CC1 and CC2. So this is coupling capacitor, basically electrolytic capacitor having polarity. So those terminal which is having long polarity, that is what we call it as a positive, and this is negative. So here this is positive connected is to be, positive terminal is to be connected to gate. So this is gate terminal, so positive terminal is to be connected in between either this hole or this hole. We can check any one, so I have taken this one.
and this terminal is to be connected anywhere in this case. Okay. Similarly, there is one more coupling capacitor, which is CC2, and its positive terminal is to be connected to drain side of FET. So this is basically drain terminals. So we have 1, 2, 3, we can connect anywhere. I have taken this positive and negative terminal, I have connected anywhere on the breadboard. Similarly, I will take source bypass capacitor, that is CCS, which is to be connected in between source terminal and ground terminal. So this is 100 microfarad basically. So this is positive and this is negative. So positive is connected to be at source terminal. So there are only two terminals we have remaining, because already one terminal of JFET is connected, then one RS terminal is connected, one connecting wire is there. So only two terminals are remaining. So I have connected here with ground. So ground, that I know this is first row of this is my ground. So I have connected CS, CC1 and CC2 in this circuit. Now I want input, because input is to be given to negative terminal of coupling capacitor number 1. So here I can have any hole I will use. Consider this hole as input. So this is my input. Similarly, at coupling capacitor 2, this green wire is my output. So we have anywhere we can use in this. So say here I have connected, this is my output. So this is my input, this is my output, and this is common is ground. So here I can use ground. So for there are two probes, so I can have two ground wire I can use. So here also I can use one ground wire. So why we call it as it is a two port device, the here is the clear understanding. This is port 1 and this is port 2, and this is the circuit. So this is amplifier having two port device, input and output. Now for giving input, we require 100 millivolt peak to peak 1 kilohertz signal, which is sinusoidal signal, and that is to be given here. So the signal setting is to be done with the help of function generator. So this is the circuit I will keep here. This is function generator, and we are using signal setting with the help of the probe. This is CRO probe, this is BNC connector, and this is crocodile end. Its mouth is like a crocodile. It has also two colors. This is black and this is red. Red color is generally considered as positive. Black color is generally considered as ground or negative. So I will connect this BNC connector in this function generator at this connector, that is, which is written 50 ohm. 50 ohm means this CRO impedance, this CRO probe impedance is 50 ohm. So I will connect here. Do not connect here and here. Okay, so this is one CRO probe I have connected. Similarly, I have CRO. So there are two channels. So this CRO we have display, and this is microcontroller base, means we can have frequency, voltage, channel 1, channel 2 settings. So there are two channels, channel 1 and channel 2. So we'll first of all we'll connect this another CRO probe in channel 1. And CRO connection is to be done like this. This red wire and red terminal is to be connected to red, and black is to be connected to black. Now I want to set a signal of 100 millivolt 1 kilohertz. Now I will on this function generator. Now I want sinusoidal waveform, because there are square and triangular, but I want sinusoidal, so I will keep sinusoidal. There are different frequency range from 2 hertz to 2 megahertz, but I want 1 kilohertz, so I have to press 2 kilohertz, and with the help of this frequency variation now I will slightly set this as 1.00. so 2 kilo and it's 1.00, so it's 1 kilohertz. Press 2k and set 1 kilohertz. Now this button like offset, symmetry and sweep, we do not use in our circuit. It is written here release adjust. Release adjust means if we release, then it will get activate. I don't want to activate them, so I will press all these three buttons. So these three buttons should be pressed always. Now I want to see the signal on this CRO
attenuation.
This is attenuation basically. If we have high amplitude and if you want to set the amplitude in particular range, then I will use this attenuation knob, minus 20 dB and minus 40 dB. And this knob is particular for varying the amplitude of the signal. So this knob will understood when we will set the signal on CRO. So this is CRO display, this is graticule, and I hope we know what do you mean by this each grid. So this is complete grid, say this is a square. So horizontally and vertically a single square is a one division, and in one division there are four small lines. So basically this is complete one division, means this is like this analogy. This is a square and this distance we call it as one division, and in between there are four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the fifth one. So definitely the meaning of this single line is 0.2 division, because it is 1 upon 5. So this distance is 0.2 division. Similarly this distance is also 0.2 division. So this is also one division and this distance is 0.2 division. This is 0.2. So this is applicable to your x axis also and y axis. Let me clear one thing. If you want to find out frequency and time, you have to take care on x axis and this time per division knob. If you want to find out voltage, then you have to take care about y axis and this channel one, which is called as volt per division knob. Now we'll see the display. Here it is written y channel 1, because I have used channel 1, and this can be changed with the help of this y. If you press this y, you will get channel 2, means this. If you want to press again y, this will get inverse this channel 2. If you want to press y again, we will get dual, means we can have both signal, this signal also as well as another signal also. Then we have y chop, means we can subtract one signal with other, add like this. So I want channel 1, so I will set y as channel 1. Then we have x is x1. x1 means original signal. If you place x is, it becomes 10, means the amplification of this signal is done by 10 times. I don't want amplification by 10 times. I want original signal. So I will press. If you want 4 trace CRO, then we have 4 different traces. So such a way this type of waveform will look, but I don't want that. So again I will press X. XY mode, if you want to find out phase difference or lesser jazz pattern, then it is XY mode. So you will get just a dot like that, or you will get a straight line or vertical line or slant line. I don't want this. If you want to find out phase difference, then we will find XY. I want, this is CT1, that is a component tester. So we'll apply certain component here and we'll find out the which component that he has tested. For example, any component if you want to find. Then next, I don't want this component testing by again 10 time magnification, I don't want, that is CT10. I want X is X1, this is very common. Then source is trigger. So trigger is TR1, means we are talking about trace, first trace, or there can be channel 2 trace, or there can be alternate trace, there can be external trace, like we have external channel also in some case, but I want trace 1. So this is always auto and this is always plus. This is frequency generally we used to display. This is channel 1 and in front of that voltage is displayed. That means the volt per division knob, and that voltage can be varied with the help of this channel 1 like this. Similarly we have channel 2 and we can vary the channel 2 knob, we can vary this channel 2 voltages. Then we have TB, this is time based scale basically. When we vary time per division knob, this TB value will get varied. Now I want 100 millivolt peak to peak 1 kilohertz. So 100 millivolt peak to peak means 0.1 volt, because we don't have 100 millivolt such value here in channel 1. So we have the range from 5 millivolt, then 10 millivolt, 20, then we have 50, then 0.1. So generally this is 100 millivolt. We have then 0.2 volt, then 0.5 volt, 1 volt, 2 volt, 5 volt, 10, 20, like that. I want 100 millivolts, so my channel 1 volt per division knob, this is volt per division knob, to be set on 0.1 volt always, if you want to find out, if you want to set 100 millivolt. So set at 0.1 volt. Now already we have said and we have got certain sinusoidal waveforms. Now but my this signal should be occupied in only one division, so that the one division into 0.1 volt will become 0.1 volt. The product should be 0.1 volt, that is 100 millivolt peak to peak. So how can we vary this amplitude? So we have this knob. This is amplitude knob. We can vary this amplitude. So we can adjust this Y position, means we can vary this vertically these positions, and we vary this amplitude knob simultaneously, so that amplitude is now reduced and this is locating in complete one division. This is called as one complete division. For example, this is called as two division. For example, this is two division. How many division is occupying single one waveform? How many division? That is two. This is complete one and this complete two. So you have to see the vertically how many division, because you are talking about voltage, you have to take care about vertical. So vertical scale is two division. This one complete one block and another block. So two, there are two squares. So this is two division, but I want one division. So you vary this amplitude so that it should occupy in one division. So now we can say truly it is in one division and the knob is at 0.1 volt. And similarly, the frequencies we have kept 2k and 1.00. So means what? Now we have done 100 millivolt peak to peak, 1 kilowatt sinusoidal waveform signal set. So such a way we have generated sinusoidal waveform of 100 millivolt, 1 kilowatts. So this is function in generator. So this is input side and this is CRO, so that is output side. So now this is what input side, that is from function generator. So this CRO probe that I will distract and I will connect to the input. So this is my input part and this CRO probe I have to connect at output, and these are the supply. So this is the way to make a setup. Okay, now I will use this red is to be connected to this because this is positive. So this is to be connected here, and similarly the ground or this black is to be connected to this terminal. Okay, so this terminal has break. I will take one more terminal, one more connecting wire like this, and like this we can connect. Now this is what we say, we have given input. Similarly, I want to find out output. So this is my output and this is positive. I will use here, and this ground definitely. So this is ground, so this black is connected to ground. So now I have done this. Now I want to give supply. Already I have set supply of 12 volts. Now I will on this supply. So already it is 12 volt. Now I will give the supply. This negative is to be given in this complete negative, that is ground part here itself. And this positive is to be given here. So anywhere we can give positive on this. So similarly I have constructed here. So simultaneously our concern is I want to see the output voltage on CRO. So see. So as we connect supply, the output voltage is getting amplified. The original output voltage was 100 millivolt, and now my output voltage is amplified and it looks like this. So we'll see how many division it occupies. It occupies, say this is from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So complete 5 division occupies. So complete 5 division occupy. So we can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 division into 0.1 volt. So we can say it is 0.5 volt. So 0.5 volt means 500 millivolt. So this is your first reading. That is your output voltage V out is 500 millivolt or 0.5 volt. Now next thing is to find out gain, that is voltage gain, which is output voltage upon input voltage. Output voltage was 500 millivolt, input voltage that I have kept constant, which was 100 millivolt. So your gain is 5. So such a way you can find out gain 5. But I want to see simultaneously the phase difference between input signal as well as output signal. So for that we can use one more connecting wire. So connect, use one more CRO probe. This is again one more CRO probe, and I will connect to the channel 2. So here I will connect to channel 2. But I want this output voltage is to be compared with input voltage. So I will connect this CRO probe to input side. This is my input side that I already made. So I will connect to this input side. So this black is to be connected to black, and this red is to be connected to red at input side. Now I have two channels. Now I have to set So now I have connected channel 2 to input. Okay, so this is input part. Now I want to see both waveform at a time. So I will press this Y. This will become channel 1 now. Now channel 2, then invert channel 2, then dual. So this is dual. So this lower one is my output and upper one is my input. So this Y position 2, how many division occupy? 1 division occupy. Okay. So this is 1 division occupy, and the knob of channel 2 is 0.1 volt. So definitely this is 0.1 volt into 1 division. So it is 100 millivolt. So my channel 2 is my input, which is 100 millivolt. Channel 2 is my output, and which is amplified. And we want to see the phase shift. For example, if you want to see the phase shift, see the phase shift. Phase shift is 180 degree. So if we reduces the volt per division knob, then see, this is called 180 degree phase shift between input and output. Okay. And see, we can have, this is 1 division and the knob is at 0.5. So we can also easily say it is a 500 millivolt or a 0.5 volt. So this is what the phase shift between input and output, which is 180 degree, and that verifies as per the theoretical thing. Now I will take out this channel 2. I don't want now dual, and I will have only one single. Now next thing is to find out RI. Next thing is to find out RI. So to find RI, we know we have to connect 1 mega ohm resistors in between negative terminal of capacitor and positive terminal of supply. So means here I will take out input and I will connect say here at certain things, and in between them I will use 1 mega ohm resistor in between them. So what I have done, between negative terminal of capacitor and input I have connected a 1 mega ohm resistor, and my output is now somehow distorted because input impedance is very high. So I can able to see, I can't change the how much division this signal occupy. Generally if we use 1 mega ohm resistors, output voltage reduces by 50%. So this is generalized theory. So my output voltage was 500 millivolt previously, then by applying R of 1 mega ohm, then whatever the output voltage that I got, that is called as VOS. So I don't want to get this value properly because I have somehow distortion. So I can find out this voltage with the help of multimeter. So I can take multimeter, because on multimeter I can see only RMS value. So I will convert into peak voltage, peak to peak voltage. So this is basically AC voltage that I got. So my rotor is switched to be connected to the AC voltage, and this is to be connected to volt. Now I will see the value on AC. So connect this red terminal to this output and black terminal to this black. So I will get certain voltage. That is my AC voltage, which is 0.095 volt. So it is 0.095 volt, but this is RMS voltage. I want peak to peak, so we have to multiply it by 2 root 2, because multiplication by root 2 will get peak voltage, and again multiplication by 2 will get peak to peak. So 0.095 into 2 root 2, that is 268. So 268 is nothing but 268 millivolt. So that my VOS is 268 millivolt. So roughly I can say that my output VOS is 250 millivolt. So 500 millivolt, and we have 50% reduction in output voltage is 250 millivolt. So if you find out, if you do the calculation, we can have VOS 250 millivolt, we can find out AVS. So we have the formula of AVS. So AVS is VOS upon Vin basically. So VOS upon Vin, so Vin is we have 100 millivolt, VOS is 250 millivolt, 250 divided by 100 is 2.5. So my AVS is 2.5. So my AVS reading is 2.5. Now for RI, we have formula AVS is AV into RI upon RI plus this R that is connected, which is 1 mega ohm, which is to be connected in between this. This is 1 mega ohm. That is basically this is to be connected in between this 1 mega ohm resistor. So this R is 1 mega ohm. This AV that I already know is 5 and this AVS is 2.5. If you find out RI is unknown, RI is 1 mega ohm. So you can able to find out RI is 1 mega ohm by this method. Okay, so this is two way to find out RI. To find, first of all connect R which is 1 mega ohm in between this and obtain the output voltage. If we get distortion, then with the help of multimeter we find out exactly the value. The value is generally 50% reduction of output voltage. Now to find RO, we make your original circuit. Means we take out this resistance and you make the circuit original. So that we will get original circuit, original waveform. Now to find RO, I will connect 1 kilo ohm resistor at output. So where basically I have to connect this 1 kilo ohm resistor. This 1 kilo ohm resistor is connected in between negative terminal of this capacitor, that is at output. Means where I have taken output, in that line itself and ground. So see, the output voltage is reduced. So output voltage is reduced drastically. Means negative terminal, basically RL, it is 1 kilo ohm resistor is to be connected. Whenever there is a negative terminal of capacitor and that line, that is positive terminal, and another is a ground. So this is ground. So here we can see clearly there is a reduction in output voltage. So output voltage reduction C can be seen on CRO, this CRO waveform. So this is complete one division and still your voltage will go beyond one division. That is, see, this is 0.2, this is 0.4 and this is 0.6. So we can say this is 1.6 division this waveform occupy. So 1.6 into 0.1. So we can say it's 1.6 into 0.1, that is VO dash. We call it as VO dash. 1.6 into 0.1. That is nothing but 0.16. We call it as 160 millivolt. So this is the way to find out VO dash. And RO can be found out by formula VO minus VO dash upon VO dash into RL. So already we have the value of RO, which is 500. 500 millivolt minus 160 millivolt divided by 160 into 1 kilo. So that is 2.125 kilo ohm. So RO is 2.125 kilo ohm. So let me clear one thing, that the values of VOS, VO dash and VO that came here in my experiment can be varied when you vary the circuit or when you vary construction. Because this BFW10, though it is same, but their values can be different. So the value of VO, VOS and VO dash can be different for different persons. But this is the way to find out AV, RI, RO and phase difference. அசோ வருங்க என்ன வரும்